Zig, 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 death in cadence, striking the tomb with his heel. Death at midnight plays a dance tune, zig, zig, zag on his violin. The winter wind blows and the night is dark. Moans are heard in the linden trees. White skeletons pass through the room, running and leaping in their shrouds. Zig, 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 each one is frisking. You can hear the clacking of the bones of the dancers. Zig, zig, zig. Death continues the unending scraping of his instrument. Zig, 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 what a saraband. They all hold hands and dance in circles. You can see in the crowd the king dancing among the peasants. But hush, all of a sudden they leave the dance. They push forward, they fly. The rooster has crowed. Oh, what a beautiful night for the poor world. Long live death and equality. That's an excerpt from a poem by Henry Casales that Sanson decided to put to music. According to legend, the Grim Reaper, or Death, appears at midnight every year on Halloween. He calls forth the dead from their graves to dance for him while he plays the fiddle. His skeletons dance for him until the rooster crows at dawn, when they must return to their graves until the next year. So if you listen carefully, you'll actually hear all of those things in the music. First thing we start with, you'll hear the harp. She plays the single note 12 times to represent the 12 strokes of midnight. You'll hear then the concertmaster is going to come in and she plays a dissonant solo representing death. And you can hear the skeletons clacking around, particularly the xylophone. And at the end, we hear the rooster's crow represented by the oboe. And then the skeletons return to their graves as dawn breaks and peace and tranquility return.
Thank you. Thank you.